Welcome to a video on estimating, multiplying, and dividing problems using whole numbers. The goal is to estimate products and quotients of whole numbers by rounding. So let's go ahead and do a quick review on how we round whole numbers. The first thing we do is identify the round-off place digit. So for these two examples, notice we want to round to the hundreds. So in both cases, the 7 is in the hundreds place value. Next, the digit to the right of the round-off place value tells us whether to round up or round down. So for this first number, the 3 tells us to round up or down, and the second example, the 6, tells us to round up or down. If the digit to the right is less than 5, we do not change the round-off place digit. If it's more than 5, we increase the round-off place digit by 1. And then we replace all digits to the right of the round-off place digit with zeros. So for this first example, this 3 tells us to round down. So we leave this as a 7 and replace the 3 and the 9 with zeros. This would be 3,700 rounded to the nearest hundreds. The second example, the 6 tells us to round up. So we do increase the 7 by 1. So we'd have 3,800. Let's go and take a look at our examples. We want to estimate this product by rounding to the nearest tens. So the 4 is in the tens and the 1 is in the tens. Notice the digit to the right in both cases is 8, which tells us to round up. So we'll round 348 to 350, and we'll round 18 to 20. And we'll use this product to estimate the original product. So remember, we'll first multiply by 0, which of course would be 0. And now we're going to multiply by 2. And since this first digit to the right is already 0, we can multiply by 2 and just put the digits right here in the same row. So 2 times 0 would be 0. 2 times 5 would be 10. So we write a 0 down and carry a 1. 2 times 3 is 6 plus 1. So we have an estimation of 7,000 for the original product. Now we should make a note that we did round both of these numbers up, so this estimation would be larger than the original product. Let's take a look at another example. Here we want to round to the nearest thousands to approximate this product. So we have a 4 in the thousands here and a 6 in the thousands here. The digit to the right here would be 3, which means we're going to round this number down. And then here we have an 8, so we'll round this one up. So we'll round this to 14,000. We'll round this to 7,000. And now we'll start to multiply. Notice the first three digits here on the right would be 0. So we'll have 3 zeros in our product. And now we'll just multiply by 7. 7 times 0 would be 0. 7 times 0 is 0. 7 times 0 is 0. 7 times 4 would be 28. We write down the 8 and carry the 2. 7 times 1 is 7 plus 2, that would be 9. So our estimation is 98 million. And notice how this was a lot less work than trying to find the original product. So if we don't have to be precise, this is a great way to estimate a product. Let's take a look at a couple division problems now. Here we want to round to the tens to approximate this quotient. So we have a 1 in the tens here and a 2 in the tens here. The 6 here tells us to round up. This 2 here tells us to round down. So we're going to round this to 820. Here we're rounding down, so we'll round this to 20. And now we'll divide. Remember, we asked how many 20s are there in 8. Well, 8 isn't big enough, so we include the next digit. How many 20s in 82? That would be 4. 4 times 20 would be 80. Remember, we subtract here. 82 minus 80 would be 2. Bring down the next digit, which is a 0. How many 20s in 20? That would be 1. 1 times 20 is 20. We have a remainder of 0. So we can say that the original quotient will be approximately 41. Let's go ahead and try another division problem. Here we'll round to the hundred thousands. So for this first number, the 3 is in the hundred thousands. And notice that On the second number, there isn't a digit in the hundred thousands, but if there was one, it would be right here. So now we'll use a digit to the right to determine whether to round up or round down. So the 7 tells us to round up. So we'll round this to 7,400,000. This 8 tells us to round up. So there really is a 0 here, so we'll increase it to 1. So this rounds to 100,000. So we're going to have to include enough digits in our dividend so that there's at least 100,000. So we'll have to go all the way over to 740,000. How many hundred thousands are there in 740,000s? That would be 7. 7 times 100,000 would be 700,000. So we subtract, that would be 40,000. Now we bring down the last digit to make this 400,000. How many hundred thousands are in 400,000? That would be 4. 4 times 100,000 is 400,000. Remainder of 0. So this quotient is approximately equal to 74. Let's take a look at a word problem. Let's say you decide to purchase 18 CFL light bulbs to save energy used to light your home. If each bulb costs $1.89, approximately how much will this cost? Notice it doesn't tell us where to round, so let's go ahead and just devise our own plan. And this might be something you do when you go to the store. Let's go ahead and round the cost to the nearest dollar. So this 8 here tells us to round up, so we're going to round the cost to $2 per bulb. So if we purchase 18 bulbs at roughly $2, so multiply 18 by 2, well 2 times 8 is 16, carry the 1, 2 times 1 is 2, plus 1, that's 3. So the cost would be approximately $36 if we purchase 18 CFL light bulbs. Okay, that's going to do it for this video. Thank you for watching.